Charles Hamilton Houston was the chief attorney for the National Association of the Advancement of Colored People. Houston was primarily responsible for developing the legal strategy that eventually led the United States Supreme Court to declare segregation in American schools unconstitutional. Born in 1895 in Washington, D.C., where his father was also a lawyer, Houston was an outstanding lawyer that graduated as one of six valedictorians from Amherst College in Massachusetts in 1915. Houston served in the U.S. Army during World War I. He also went on to serve as the dean of Howard University Law School. Among Houston's students were Thurgood Marshall, Oliver Hill, and Spottiswood Robinson, all whom would play major roles in overturning segregation in the courts from 1935 to 1939. Houston served as special counsel for the NAACP and became the architect of the legal challenge to Jim Crow. Houston actually toured the South collecting information to support his belief that black and white schools were unquestionably unequal. In every southern state, Houston believed that the weakest chain in segregation was education. Houston applied his belief that if the NAACP could build up enough smaller victories in the courts, there would be enough precedents established for the court to eventually declare all forms of segregation in education unconstitutional. Charles Hamilton Houston did not live to see his dream become reality. His efforts came to fruition only after his death in 1950. The historic Brown v. Board of Education of Topeka, Kansas decision to prohibit segregation in public schools came in 1954. We are deeply grateful for Charles Hamilton Houston's work and efforts to make the basic civil rights to education more equitable. We are part of his legacy. We are the legacy. But as students whom are currently receiving special education services, we feel that legacy Houston fought for and won with Brown v. Board of Education has been compromised.
Mr. Houston was born a long time before Brown versus Board. He was born in 1908, and he grew up in a time during segregation. When he served in World War I, and he served in the segregated unit, where it was an all-black unit. They weren't allowed to serve in the same units as the white individuals. So he experienced this separate but equal thing very much so in real life. I mean, he knew what it was like. And when he came back to the States, he attended law school at Harvard, which they weren't separated. Now, they did have him sit outside the classroom, but they did allow him to attend the institution. So he attended Harvard, then he went on to practice law, and he became the dean of Howard University, which is a historically black college institution. And as the dean of that institution, Thurgood Marshall then attended the law school there and had the ability to be taught by Charles Hamilton Houston. And it was that teaching that he gave to Thurgood Marshall that helped train him to fight these separate but equal cases, and that led up to the Brown versus Board of Education case.
I most certainly feel that segregation exists in education today, especially surrounding the placement of children in special education services. Special education really came about after the Brown decision, and since that time, the number of people of color that have been placed in special education systems and programs have just increased. And also, as a result, the literacy level of people of color have really decreased, as well as the graduation rates decreasing. And so when you look at schools, even like our school, and you begin to analyze how many students that we have in our level 4 setting that are African American.
Straight A student before I got put in SPAN in the 5th grade. After I got put in SPAN, my grades fell, my behavior got worse, and I noticed that all of us in SPAN were black. I feel like being in SPAN made me miss out on things others get to do. I had to fight for the education I wanted. I fought for African American studies since the 10th grade. and I got it when I was in 12. I want to go to college. My mom and I are tired of fighting for the decent education that we both feel like I deserve.
You're supposed to just be this strong person. And so it breaks a person when you're in a system and you don't feel equal, that I'm a senior in name only, but I don't do what other seniors do. I don't go to prom, and I'm not exposed to a journalism class, and everything that I have to do, I'm monitored and I'm watched and I'm locked down, and everything about my existence in school represent what the world says prisons and jail look like. And so if the schooling experience in America is to prepare students for society, then every aspect of schooling should mirror society.
No one is wrong or right.
When I was younger, before I was in any education services, I was kind of like in a white school in the suburbs. And I ain't gonna lie, like my mom was on drugs and that affected me at school, like problems from home, come to school, like yeah. So, but it wasn't like I was the only one that showed more behavior problems, but I showed the most in the more extreme behavior problems, so they put me in SPAN type stuff. And I feel like schools like this, it's kind of like jail, kind of, because it's preparing me, it's like preparing me for jail. Because, like, when you go to jail, you start to feel like a criminal. So when I got in SPAN, I began to feel SPAN.
Hold your head as high as you can, high enough to see who you are, little man. Life sometimes is cold and cruel, maybe no one else will tell you, so remember that you are black gold, black gold. You are black gold. Now maybe no one else has ever. Black gold with a diamond sword. high enough to see you.
High enough to see who you
are. Life sometimes is cold and cruel,
maybe colder than us will tell you, so remember that you are,
you are,
you are. Your head.